Hey, welcome back to the channel. Now, as you may or may not be aware, Universal Audio have released the native version of their Ampex 102 master tape. This goes along with the Shuda A800 and the Oxide tape and a couple of others they make, but the Ampex is now available native. Now, I was going to do a review of this plugin, but I thought there's a bit of a wider discussion that we might need to have, because the question on my mind is, what exactly is it that Universal Audio are doing? So let me explain. So, for the past decade, however long it's been, you've had to have Universal Audio hardware, be it the PCI cards, the interfaces, the satellite, all that kind of thing, to be able to run their plugins, which worked off DSP, right? And this was their unique selling point. This is what kind of reeled you into UA's domain, was, you know, you buy our hardware, you get our plugins. Now, Universal Audio traditionally have always made very, very good plugins. They are, to this day, some of my favourites. Their 1176 plugins, the LA2As, all that kind of thing, just sound incredible. And the Ampex is no different. It sounds absolutely fantastic as far as the tape plugin goes. However, the decision to go native, I find to be a very strange one. And the reason is, if we look at Universal Audio as a brand, and look at their interfaces specifically, their Apollos, you know, the maximum I/O you can get from a Universal Audio interface is 16 I/O. Now, that's beaten in the market by Antelope, who make the Orion, and the Galaxy, which has 64. You've got Ferrofish, you've got RME, you've got Lynx. There are many other people out there making 32 I/O units, albeit some of them expensive, but still, they are available. All right, so if we discount that, then let's look at price. Where does the Apollo sit in the market? Well, they're pretty expensive. They're up there with some of the most expensive. All right, we're not competing on price. Connectivity. Thunderbolt 3, and they've just released a new line of Dante interfaces if you want to go down the Dante route. So not doing anything proprietary there. Everybody else has Thunderbolt 3. Loads of other interfaces have Dante. So nothing unique there, and they're not competing on that front either. How about software? So the software that comes with an Apollo, the UA control software, is generally very good. It's very reliable. It's very user-friendly. So yeah, that's cool. Thumbs up for the software side of things, but again, not something I'd really call a unique selling point, so they're not really competing on that front. It's not like they've got the best software in the world. All right, conversion. What about AD conversion? Nope. They're not the best on the market by a long stretch. I would argue that Lynx have better conversion. Apogee. Definitely Antelope. There's plenty of other. Focusrite, the Red 16 line, has got pretty good sounding conversion in it. For me, technology's come such a long way now that converters aren't as big of a deal as they used to be. And, you know, back in the days where people were spending tens of thousands of pounds for conversion, I mean, some people still do. Hey, your mileage may vary. But, you know, generally speaking, in a lower-end budget interface these days, the converters are acceptable. And as you go up that market, up that ladder, they only get exponentially better. So it's not like UA are coming to market with a fresh take on conversion or anything like that. So they're not competing there either. So why on earth would anybody buy a Universal Audio interface? So we haven't got market-leading conversion. We don't have market-leading I/O. We don't have market-leading connectivity. We don't have market-leading software. And we're more expensive than most other people. What's the draw? Well, the draw was the DSP on board for the plugins. This is what made it a whole package, which made Universal Audio attractive, in my opinion. And now it seems like they're trying to murder that as well. Because by making the plugins native, you just don't need to buy their interfaces anymore. This to me is crazy. Like, they're putting R&D into making Apollos, which have Dante, and the, you know, they're still releasing new units. Why bother? because you're killing your own line of products. Because if they're not going to compete on other avenues, you know, be it more I.O., better converters, you know, something to make them stand out in the market, what's the point? Because that just, to me, makes them a bang average, very expensive interface. I don't understand the line of going native, I really don't. I mean, I get it, they want to sell more plugins, right? Totally get it, I get that as a business decision, but when you're still actively peddling your interfaces and your DSP chips, does it not seem a little bit counterproductive to actively try to kill them at the same time? Because, all right, some of you may say, not all of UA's plugins are available native. And they're not. Yeah, but they will be. They will be eventually. If enough people start buying the plugin subscriptions and all that kind of thing, they'll make them native, and then their interfaces will be completely obsolete. Now, I saw a trend of this happening when the UAD native thing first came out. When it first came to the market and all the classic compressors and all that kind of thing were available, the price of used Apollos went... Because traditionally, Apollos had always held the value, but wow, they absolutely plummeted off a cliff face. You couldn't sell them fast enough because all of a sudden, you've invested thousands of pounds into a platform that the developer is trying to kill. It just seems like a crazy decision to me. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe there's something that I've missed. Let's have a discussion in the comments. If you think I've missed something or there's a point in this that I'm not understanding or that I've neglected to think about, hey, opinions are open to change, and if I can hear new information that changes my mind, by all means, I would love to discuss it with you guys, because there's some of you out there that know a lot more about this stuff than I do, but this is my perspective on Universal Audio currently. I just don't understand what's going on with them. I really don't. Anyway, that's my thoughts on the general UA thing. As far as the Ampex plugin goes, I've got something fancy coming in the next couple of weeks that I think is going to be interesting for you. So keep your eyes peeled for that. But until we meet again, be well. And also, don't forget to subscribe, or super thanks, or anything like that would be cool. But there's like 98% of people who watch the videos that are not subscribed. I don't need to beg. You know what's going on. Hit the button. See you next time.